My interventions are the performances. I guess the thread is this idea of relational aesthetic, that the main thing is you're creating these exchanges.
How many Zen masters does it take to change a light bulb?
Maybe there's levels of empowerment through these exchanges.
And he's super into technical skills.
Welcome to the DMV.
The DMV for me always represented a system of herding cattle. I would be there and I felt like a number. So thinking about that space within its social, isolated point, I wanted to do a performance that would counter that point of alienation through a system of humor and comfort. It was pretty much looking at the idea of gift giving. There's this exchange, and also the idea of artists as the fool. I put on the responsibility of being the fool by the ridiculous dancing and the ridiculous jokes. The form of performance found its way into, I guess, how I personally interact within these social settings. And it's just based on this gut feeling that there's something going on that I don't like. And then I analyze myself about what is bothering me. And once I can point to those areas, that might be a space, it might be how people are interacting with each other, there might be a factor that there's not enough of something. Then, once I can target it and address it, I think about what forms, whether it be costumes, actions, you know, exchanges, that can alter that situation. And then I go about researching in terms of if it's involving humor, if it's involving the idea of gift giving, if it's involving the idea, such as the time now I'm studying the phenomena of boredom within our society, or within a cultural setting, where does boredom come into play? You know, is boredom a reaction to a certain stimulus? The do-nothing chair, I don't know what the outcome of that's going to be yet. You know, I sometimes question, when I have time off, why isn't it enough that I can sit on a couch versus thinking I have to do something? Where does boredom fall within our cultural setting? Is it a system of withdrawal from a stimulus? What happens if we allow boredom to set in over a period of time? Do we become content with that boredom? Can we? What does that say about cultural stimulus? It's about the research. And it's also about making an argument for that piece. Otherwise, it becomes just these random actions. They aren't grounded in anything. Arm wrestling, it takes a different direction in terms of ideas of comfort. It's rupturing comfort spaces, those isolated spaces, such as openings at museums, openings at galleries, where we create something that looks like a real situation that could be uncontrollable and that might threaten that comfort zone. The Superman safety crossing piece was more performative in the sense that there was a duty required and that was helping people cross the street. But I did put myself in that character, and that was part, I guess, of that, what you would call the artist practice, that there was restrictions in terms of what I was going to do within this costume. And what happened was, because Superman is such a cultural icon, people were projecting their fantasies upon me, and it became a system of play. And the common thread is the exchange. There's creating the exchange, you know, a system that's familiar, and it might be seductive to... whether it be humor or whatever, for a person to want to incorporate themselves, you know. In another common thread, it is situational, you know. And whatever circumstances I find myself that I want to address that space, that time, that situation. And it is about, you know, overall socialization.